since we kind of just got through the more personal, more one-on-one individual questions, I do want to shift gears and turn it to more of an open roundtable discussion, questions that everyone or anyone, whoever feels it more inclined to answer, can answer. And then we'll open it up to the crowd because I know they have a couple questions as well. But excuse me, I want to let you guys know we are moving into our last question, and it is going to come from one of the people in the crowd. I believe his name's Kevin, and he wanted to ask about in terms of health and wellness, are there any morning or evening routines that are key for helping out, you know, your health and your wellness? And again, this question is open to all of our lovely panelists, so anyone feel free to go ahead and answer.
So I can start with that, unless Joshua, you want to go ahead and start.
Ladies first.
Thank you. I try to, I have moved my career in a place where I start my day when I want to. So I like to wake up without an alarm. Whenever my body is ready, that's when I'm coming to the world today. So I do that. I take my time. Diffusers are a daily part of my life, be it peppermint and lavender or citrus, whatever is going to either help me to come up or help me to come down. Music is a part of my life. I'm very musical. I wake up with different songs in my head every day, and I listen to whatever is in my head and my heart. And then I start my day. My day typically starts around noon. Except during the semesters and I teach. And then at night, I'm very, 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 very conscious of how I come down, right? And so leaving work, I'm typically intentional about who I spend my time with, if I spend my time with anyone, who I talk to, if I talk with anyone, because it's a time of decompression for me. Lighting is important for me, natural light, natural moonlight, and coming down intentionally. You know, I don't use my phone after a certain time. My phone's on do not disturb a lot of the time, so that I can ground myself, right? Some of what the doctor was saying, just really do some, excuse me, breathing exercises, because sometimes my mind will go. And so I'm aware of that. Okay, I'm thinking a lot. Let me do some deep breathing. Let me release this before I go to bed. Let me write this down so that it's not hindering my sleep, you know, things like that. So very intentional in how I wake up and go to sleep.
And I can piggyback that, because that's a big thing too that comes up with people. You know, there's many different ways of getting to make sure you wake up with a clear mind and focus, depending on your intention, again, being intentional. And there's many ways with which you can go to sleep depending on what's happening with you. And again, it's a very individualized process. This is where my work as a medical intuitive comes in place, because when you look at people and you see what's going on, you can immediately tell you need to learn how to really unplug before you go to bed, because you're taking all the crap that happened to sleep with you, and you're not unplugging, and you're not even having restful sleep. Or it might be as simple as the alcohol you drank that doesn't even get you into a restful phase of sleep to detox. That's part of the liver problem that you keep having. So that will then determine what can happen for you as far as your nighttime routine. Breath work for me is like standard. Breathing is life. Breathing is connection to spirit. Breathing is connection to God and to the other side. And you can use it in so many ways to help you whatever way you need to get to sleep. But it depends on where you are with your healing process or your developmental process. Like me now wanting to develop a certain spiritual side of me, there are certain things I put into place ritualistically or with breath work to be able to get there. And again, waking up in the morning, some people, first thing they do is running for a cup of coffee. That makes the mind run all over the place. For some people, that's actually helpful, but is it helpful for you? Mm-hmm. And so, and then that's where I tell people there's so much information overload out there that you really need to start learning how to tune into what works best for you, which is one of the things that I work on with people and say, for you, no, that's not going to work. Or this is going to work. Waking up in the morning again, if you really want to get grounded within yourself, it's breath work and breathing and talking about who do I want to be today? How do I want my life to go today? And every time you feel yourself getting off kilter with that during the day. You breathe and remind yourself how you started. People harp on physical exercise and all that. And I am a very physical exercise type person. I'm there. But what's more important, especially as you age, is being more intentional with the mental, emotional exercises when you wake up, and using that same pattern even with your workout process, not just going through an auto mode. Auto mode is like, without being conscious, auto mode is something you need to eliminate in your life, okay? You need to get more intentional about everything you eat, what you feed your mind before you go to sleep at night. What are you watching? When do you need to disconnect and unplug from social media or whatever drama, whatever it is you're paying attention to? So again, a lot of that is dependent. And a lot of times people know what their problems are. They don't want to face, because when they come and talk to me and I say, you need to do this, well, I know. And I know. So I'm here to say, just do it. So I put that again on your prescription. Have you da 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 da? So that's really what the morning and nighttime routine should be specific for you. But again, a lot of those healthy practices with unplugging. Drink water when you first wake up in the morning. Don't drink coffee. Don't drink, because your body is in a state where it needs to release toxins after you slept. So the first thing you want to do after you do your breath work and get up, drink some water. Anyway, that's it.
Well, I love everything I'm hearing so far. Again, I agree with LaQuanya that for me, waking up in the morning is on my own terms, on my own body. I do struggle with some physical issues. I do struggle with mental health issues. So for me, and aging. So I'm definitely an aging athlete. I'm asking of my body things that are, there's nobody out there like me doing what I'm doing. I'm a unicorn. There's nobody that's asking their body in this gender, this ethnicity, this age, what I'm asking of my body. So for me, I really need that sleep in the morning. A lot of times I can't do things super early because it just doesn't work with my body chemistry, my body, what it's asking of me. My body wants to be sound asleep at 5, 6, 7, and 8 in the morning. That's what's good for me. That works for me. And then, like you say, what you're feeding, I have extreme chemical and sensitivities and food allergies. I'm extreme. I'm like 100. Okay. So everything I eat, I'm conscious about everything that I put in my body, on my body, everything. Again, getting into our culture is that we use a lot of toxic stuff in our life. We use a lot of toxic things. Sometimes I can't go to a Black party. I can't go to a Latino party because it's going to be too filled with toxic perfumes and things like that, that make me instantly ill, like I will lose days of my life over it. So because I'm such this unique, sensitive kind of empathic creature, I just have to do life differently than most people. So like you say, with breath work, with meditation, finding out who you really are before you start the hustle bustle of the day, breathe in the positivity of who you want to be, how you want to impress and inform the world. What do you want to say to the world today? So I breathe. It helps me get to sleep. It helps me wake up. It just helps me connect with God and the universe. It's just the breath work, the meditation, the intention, the purposefulness. So I love everyone here. I love what you guys are saying because it's so on the right path that we're trying to open up. And again, be these kind of vessels, these examples. Because we're just out there trying to do it ourselves. Nobody here is perfect. Nobody here is getting it right every day. That's for dang sure. I'll tell you that right now. But we know what we're attempting every single day. Every single day. And the same with night, bringing it down. I'm lacking some things in my life that I feel humans need, humans want. I'm single. I lack a lot of human affection. I lack a lot of things that I feel like as humans, as animals, we need. And so how do I supply that to myself, which hasn't been supplied to me in the form of a partner or a child? I don't even have my dog anymore. He went and left me, So just this conscious, meditation and breathing in what it is we want and how we're going to explore our bodies and how we're going to explore our souls and our minds. How are we going to be a little bit better than we were yesterday? That's really my goal. When I'm waking up in the morning, how can I do this day?
Reaffirmations, guys. Reaffirmations of your self-love. Reaffirmations of the self-awareness to have love, reaffirmations to let yourself know that you're worthy. You woke up another day. You not only woke up another day, but it's another day for another opportunity. And we don't take that and sit on that and value that in the actual miracle that it is. I mean, if you really think about it, none of us were really supposed to be born if we're betting on the real factor of life. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's yeah. A billion shot for every single one of us to be here. So that in and of itself is like a miraculous event, like that just transpired and is continuously growing and happening. Take accountability of that. Don't just awe-inspire yourself into things, but do realize the gravity of what it is to be you in this time, in this place, in this now, good and bad. None of it is gonna just keep you where you're at unless you choose to. Everything is gonna continue pushing you whether you're going forward or backwards. It's just a matter of what you're valuing yourself out of that situation, what you're valuing yourself like. So in the mornings, reaffirmations. It doesn't even matter if it sounds ridiculous. Make it sound ridiculous. We watch boxes. We're looking at each other through screens right now. Let's not play these games that ridiculousness is somehow a thing anymore. Stop pretending like this embarrassing thing that you know you have to do for your well-being and sanity should be this thing that you hide. Stop pretending. Stop living inside this closeted place of standards because of what the world used to be at one point. That's not helping your mornings. It's not helping you with your gut. It's not helping you with your foods. It's not helping you with your mental and all of these different things that we continue to try to elevate. All of that starts off with you having the thought, and you can't have the thought if you're not feeding the thought. That's why the food matters. That's why the sleep matters. So self-care and self-awareness in the practice of that is what I take care of myself like every morning. If I don't get all of the hours I want out of my sleep, I'm not just making it like the rest of my day is ruined. No, I'm looking for, the military used to do this thing where they had you hunt the good stuff. And so everywhere that I look and every moment that I have, I look at the little things that I do have going for me. Yes, I might have been homeless 3 times, but at the very least I had a place that I could put my head to sleep.
So that you just reminded me of hashtag gratitude.
Hashtag gratitude.
Is would be my number one answer. And I'm piggybacking off of you, Elvis, that with every breath work, with every meditation, with every prayer, I'm trying to remind myself, even on the worst of times, which I've kind of been in the worst of times this past week or so, what can I be grateful for? And breathe into that. Breathe into that goodness and that gift. So now it can cycle through me and I can give it out now. And so that's a big part of my breath work, my meditation, is just breathing in gratitude.
Reaffirmation, gratitude.
So thank you, Elvis.
Yeah, and thank you, everyone. I know we're a little over time. So Joshua, and you know, you're here. I wanna let you also get the opportunity, let us know what your routine is, and Anthony, before we bring this to a close, but I wanna be courteous to everyone's time. But then again, thank you all for being a part of this and for everyone for staying long, because this is a great conversation. But Joshua, please, let us hear from you.
No, for me, I've made it a thing ever since I was a child. I've meditated, but I've become even better as I've gotten older, is the intentionality to meditate before I go to sleep and then meditate when I wake up. It's the gratefulness and it's the reaffirmations of what he was talking about. It's making sure that you showing yourself appreciation and not devaluing that it takes so much to wake up every day. It takes so much to go through this crazy thing we call life and do it consistently every day. And every day is different with different challenges. It's meditation for me has really helped me love myself, really pay attention to the intentionality of just not having to worry about who's going to think about this and who's none of that, just focusing truly on myself. Because if you can't love yourself, you can't love nobody else. And that's just the facts.
Yeah, no, that's amazing. I definitely feel that meditation has been major for me as well. I like to start my mornings off. I'm an early riser though. I do like to start my mornings off pretty early, but I do like to get active. I like to get a nice sweat in, whether it's running or working out. And then I like to come back and engage in some type of reading. I love reading. I read a lot of books. So I try and like activate like my mind, body, soul. So I like to work out, come back, you know, shower, read for a little bit, eat probably like some fruits or something that's gonna kind of give me energy for the day. Nothing too sugary. Well, I mean, fruits are sugary, but like in a good way, but like nothing too like artificial. And then just kind of, you know, make the to-do list and kind of get to it. I definitely do like meditating. I don't necessarily do it as soon as I wake up, but I definitely make time for it after I kind of get into my day, after I get into, you know, just what I kind of have to do. I like to take, you know, like walks, just, you know, with the phone at home, you know, mid throughout the day, just so I can kind of, you know, have that clarity and kind of clear space so I can, you know, just make time for myself. Since, you know, I am kind of just hustling and bustling around and whatnot. But in the mornings, I do find that I like I said, I like rising early because I like the time where no one's out in the streets, no one's out and about. There's no cars going. There's no, you know, that outside noise that we're kind of we're just so used to. So I like kind of having that peace and quiet in the morning, like where I can go and get active, come back, read, eat some fruit, and just, you know, get the day started and bring in just good energy and good vibes to carry throughout the day.